हेलो फ्रेंड्स, इन दिस वीडियो विल डिस्कस लॉ ऑफ असॉल्ट। तो लेट अस सी व्हाट यज्ञवल्का हैज मेंशन एंड हैज सेड रिगार्डिंग द लॉ ऑफ असॉल्ट इन हिज स्मृति। व्हेन देयर इज एन इंजुरी, इट इज नेसेसरी टू हैव इट प्रॉपरली चेक्ड, एज देयर आर चांसेस दैट द इंजुरी मे बी अ फॉल्स वन। इफ असॉल्ट इज डन इन फॉलोइंग मैनर, fine would be imposed by throwing mud, by throwing dust, by spitting, by throwing food on somebody while eating. If somebody lift a weapon with the intention to assault but does not do any assault, still he has to pay the fine. If somebody picks up the weapon and keeps it down, still he has to pay the fine. So friends, if you see the law of assault which existed at that point of time, one important aspect which we can see is attempt to do a crime was also punishable with fine. And not only attempt to do a fine, but just merely picking up a weapon, that also was considered as a crime, and for that fine was imposed. Let's go further and see what more is said on assault by Yajnavalka. Fine has to be paid if assault is done in following manners: by pulling legs, by pulling hairs, by pulling clothes, by pulling hands, hitting by wooden stick, hitting on teeth, for tearing of ears, for tearing of nose, for hitting on eyes. So friends, if you keep this in mind, what we have just read, all this is properly covered as a crime in the present day criminal law. So again, this makes us to think that there are roots of our present criminal law in our ancient law, so that the present law somewhere must have emerged from the ancient laws which prevailed in India. Let us see further what Yajnavalka says on the assault. Whoever injures other has to pay for his medical expenses. Whoever purposely creates sorrow in somebody's house or tries to throw poison, he would be required to pay fine. If somebody kills animals and removes their parts, he is liable to pay the fine. When survival of somebody is dependent upon the tree, and if somebody cuts that tree, he is liable to pay the fine. If somebody cuts auspicious trees like peepal, palash, etc., he is liable to pay the fine. So friends, we can see that how in detail the law existed. The assault did not remain, if you see properly, the assault did not remain up to human beings. It went further. Like it says that if somebody's survival is on a tree and that tree is cut, that was an assault. It is further said that auspicious trees like people, palash, if they are cut, that was an assault. Today we have separate laws for tree cuttings, but they are considered as different laws. In ancient times, what we can see is assault as such has got merged with human assault as well as assault on animals. Because again here it says the animal is assaulted, his parts are removed. So assault as a whole had both human beings, non-human beings. Whereas as on today, we have assault divided into two parts. One is for the human beings, we have separate laws. For animals, we have separate laws. For trees. But in those days, assault as such was covered under one particular head in a one particular chapter. So friend, this was law of assault as mentioned in Yajnavalkya Smriti. Now we will see certain acts which are punishable with fine. Thank you.